Well, it hasn't happened in 26 years. News 8's Ken Pierce is live in New Haven, where preparations are underway for the game between the Ivy League team and Army. Tell us about it, Kent.
Yeah, Jim, it is going to be quite a spectacle here at the Yale Bowl tomorrow. If you think there's a lot of pomp and fanfare around the Harvard-Yale game every year, imagine this. 1,000 West Point cadets are going to march down the street around the Yale Bowl and then inside. And how are the game balls going to get onto the field, you may ask? They're going to have paratroopers jump out of helicopters, parachute down to the 50-yard line. All that's before they even start playing the game. It's part of the celebration of the field itself. The Yale Bowl turns 100 years old this year. When it was built, it was the largest stadium of its kind. Army, no stranger here. They've played here a couple dozen times in a rivalry with Yale that dates back 130 years. They've played 45 times, these two teams, but not so much in the past few decades. So this is a pretty rare spectacle. It's why there is so much pomp and fanfare around it. But, you know, this rivalry goes back so far because back when they were first coming up with the idea of the Ivy League, it actually contained the 8 current members and West Point, too. So, long-time rivalry. Last time they played, Army beat Yale quite handily, but there's a lot of respect between these two teams. Kickoff is at 1:05 tomorrow. Yeah, we're expecting 40,000 people out here, but the good news is you can probably still get a ticket because the Yale Bowl actually seats more than 60,000. Live at the Yale Bowl in New Haven, I'm Kent Pierce. Back to you.